So once this is completed, I actually want to make a new template that's going to help us carve out the outside shape of this lamp to the appropriate dimensions, and also to cut these grooves and things into the part. So I'm going to make an exterior template now, and we're going to go back to our original sketch. I'm going to hide this body, and we can go back to this sketch here, and we're going to start building a template on the outside. So again, we're going to sketch. I'm going to make an extra line out here just to be able to have something to clamp to. Like that. So I can make this a vertical line. So we're going to make these parallel. And I'm also going to do a very similar thing over here, where I take another line and just extend this out. I'm going to make this a vertical line, and I'm going to make these two lines parallel. And then I'm going to select this line and all of the associated edges here, and I'm going to also make an offset, and that's going to be the basis of our template. So this goes all the way around. I can select these. We're just going to make a simple offset here like that. And we'll call this 10 millimeters. This is going to vary based on where your bearing location is going to be on your router bit and how long the router bit is and things like that. But this is going to be adjustable. So as your tools change, you can change out what those dimensions actually are. So we're going to get the rough tool built like this. Just make this a vertical line. And I'm going to just to cap off this sketch area. And that gives us something that we can extrude. So with that, we now have a new body, or we can start to make a new body for making a template to make these parts. So I'm going to make this the same as the original body that we were working on. So we're just going to say 50. And it should line up with our previous body. So we can look at it together. So we can use this template as a clamping piece, or we can add this after the fact.